Shalom Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Friends, just a quick update here. Been on the road, and we had a wonderful meeting there in Orlando last night. We're able to share some very deep insights of things that are going on, especially concerning Israel, things about my own past that we were able to share with the people there in Orlando. And I think it really helped a lot of people to really understand our love for Israel, but yet our disdain for what is happening to the Israeli people with this movement, this Vatican movement, the Vatican agenda that is robbing the Jewish people by setting up a new world order, bringing about an ungodly new world order inside of Israel to begin with, and how we're being fought against by Jesuits that have infiltrated not only Israel and the Israeli government, but they're also using Mossad agents against us as well. It is a terrible thing that we see that is happening, and we have been trying to expose this. And some things we hold back on publicly, but in these private meetings, we're not holding back. We're telling you the truth. We're bringing things out in a way that, you know, is making a lot more sense. I got to do a little bit of working on my own past there because I have so much information of when I worked with the federal government there that I have been a little reluctant in how I bring it out. And even in Orlando, I didn't do the job that I should have done. My wife has heard the story since I began to break my silence about what has gone on in the past and how this affects so many in the world today. Politicians, even as high up as former presidents of the United States that have been involved in cover-ups of operations that I've been involved in myself. We're going to be sharing this more and more, though, in Nashville. We'll be sharing very detailed, and I'll be working on that presentation to make it very clear, very informative, so people can really understand what's really going on. And also the exposing of the agenda that's happening in the government of the United States today that is driving us to a new world order, and no one is paying attention to this. I'm going to be sharing more of those things as well. But let me go quickly in the news what we saw this happening today. In Chicago, Illinois, this weekend, 60 people have been shot. 9 of them have died from those gunshot wounds. Now, what's troubling to me is, of course, it's again being blamed on the black community of all this violence. But, you know, this is something that I learned as well back when I worked with the government. Blaming things on the black community is a scapegoat. And unfortunately, that happens when it shouldn't be happening. Not to say that there's not enough violence that goes on and gang-related activities, drug wars, etc. But I also know there are things that are perpetrated by secret organizations that are done intentionally and then blamed on the black community. And I've wondered if that's not what's happening in Chicago. And moving on over towards Israel now, let me go into that issue as well. VeteransToday.com put out an article about the natural gas supplies. The second world's largest natural gas supply is actually believed to be under Gaza and off the coast of Gaza. This could explain why some of the elites in the government are very bent on keeping the blockade against Gaza. And you have to understand, this is not a self-hating Jewish side saying this. I'm trying to understand and recognize why the issue of Gaza has become such a major importance, much like Syria. Why did they take down Syria? Well, also speaking about Syria, Idlib, where the last stand is at, and Latakia, where Russia has their military base, is also another massive natural gas world reserve right there. It also involves the panhandle of Turkey that comes down and separates the Mediterranean Sea and that of Idlib in the Syrian province. So this is why we're seeing all these battles. And in fact, speaking of battles, now the U.S. has got an agreement working out that they're going to get to rebuild eastern Syria. Tells you that President Bashar al-Assad doesn't really have the control of his country that he thinks he does. But all the world's elite and leaders there are dividing this country up between themselves. And I think that's what's going to come down at the end of the day. It's the same thing in Israel. Yeah, they're not going to have two states, one state. It's going to be a regional block. And eventually, something's going to happen that's going to break, that's going to give Israel the right, no doubt, to be able to get the gas off of Gaza's coast and maybe even under the land there as well. It is a mess, guys, but this has nothing to do with Jew or Gentile here and that relation there. This is all about a new world order. This is about mega corporations and robbing of resources and taking from the poor to give to the wealthy, to the rich of the world. It's the same old thing that it was 30 years ago when I was in the intelligence community as it is today. Doesn't seem much has changed except maybe technology. Speaking of technology, yeah, the new phones that we have today that they're coming out with, that AI technology, you know, my phone suddenly decides to dial 911 today while I'm talking to my wife. Why did that happen? Well, we begin to wonder about it because when 911 asked me, I said, I never dialed your number. I'm on the phone with my wife and suddenly you guys call, or my phone calls you. Well, my wife got to thinking about it and she said, you know, perhaps our daughter gets upset when daddy goes out of town. She gets nervous about it. If mama were to go somewhere, she's nervous about mama going. And she was crying about this. Maybe the phone sensed the stress and dialed it for us anyway. Makes you wonder if we really do want a next generation anything. I'm beginning to think I don't really think so. I'm Steve Benoon with Israeli News Live, Erev Tov. Don't forget to support the ministry, israelinewslive.org. As soon as we get back in on, what is it, Wednesday, I guess, we'll be back down at the studio again there. We'll be back in studio getting things put together for you guys a whole lot better than what we're doing now. Erev Tov.